Everybody, Doug here. Welcome back to the channel. Welcome back to this Mystic Eye Games Kickstarter preview of Gods of Metal. This is a deck building game designed by Christopher Brown and published by Laughing Rogue Games. It accommodates 1 to 4 players, takes approximately 60 to 90 minutes, and is for ages 14 and up. In this game, you are playing a heavy metal band that is defending the world against an onslaught of demons from another dimension, led by fiendish overlords that are trying to break through and destroy everything. To do this, you're going to play music, create songs, attach things to your, game equipment like a microphone or a new guitar or something like that. And you're going to do that by purchasing cards from the row in the deck. And we're going to do the final setup. I'm going to talk about the order of gameplay and what's in the game right now. So let's get started and talk through a game of Gods of Metal, so you can determine when this kickstarts again in November, I think November 17th, you will be able to decide if this is a game that is right for you. Now, I am a fan of deck-building games, all the way back from the original. Bonus points, if you can put the original, the very first deck-building game that ever existed, that was popular anyway, in the chat. I think we all know what it is, but just if you, bonus points for you, nothing to win here, but bonus points for you if you can put it in the chat. But there have been others, and more recently there have been several good ones. I can think of Aeon's End, which has a very unique twist on it and has several versions of it that has come out. Clank and Clank Legacy game, all of those have come out. There's plenty of great deck builders. Is this one of those? Well, let's see. Now, this is not a review. This is a preview, so I'm not going to give you my personal opinions on the game. I have played through several rounds of it, so I have a good idea of how it plays. And I am a general fan of deck building games. And I think this metal theme with the demons attacking is rather interesting and unique. But let me just show you how things get set up, because it's pretty straightforward. And that way we'll get ready to give you an idea how to play the game. But the first thing you have to do is set up the board. The first thing you do is you select your band members, but we're going to go through the board setup real quick. This here is the metal deck, and we are going to, when you first set it up and you put out the board, you're going to place 5 cards in the metal deck that are purchasable during your turn. We'll go over a little bit about what these cards are. Now, you can see by the card images that this has a very heavy metal theme, which is super cool, and this kind of reminds me of the old 90s rock and rollers with all the skulls and demons and stuff like that. It's pretty neat. Up in the corner, you have the cost of the card to purchase using metal tokens. These up here are your metal tokens. Metal tokens is one of the currencies in the game. In a lot of games, you can say that like some of them have points to spend, like in the legendary games, you can get influence points to influence certain characters to come to your side. In this game, it's metal. And then you also have decibels, which allow you to do a number of things in the game, including do damage. These are decibel tokens, right there. Now you can see that there's a number of things that happen in here. I'll give you an example of one. Let's bring it up close. This is Screamer. It's an instrument upgrade for the vocalist. It means he has a wild scream or something like that he can do. And we'll talk about why this is important in a moment. You want the vocalist to have this, because you have to attach it to your vocalist, and that's what that means. That's your singer, your headline singer, right? And once you attach this, it remains in play with that character. Now, you're not going to get that right away, because like a deck builder, you're going to purchase this and put it in your discard pile. When it comes up again, you can attach it. But when it's attached, you may buy a single card from the metal row for -2 points. So that's every turn. Just one card, but because you can buy multiple cards, like in most deck builders. And you must be discarded when a song is played. So once we've played a song, your crazy scream is no longer effective. We also have another upgrade up here, which is called Newman. It's an instrument for the bass guitarist, and it says to attach to him. It says when attached, all players gain +2 decibel tokens. That's pretty good. It must be discarded when the song is played. So again, you can see that the instruments get used until a song is played. And then we just have some cards that have special abilities. This frenzied ability says effect. So effect is when you play the card. You gain 2 metal tokens and 1 decibel, or you can place 1 decibel on an overlord. That's like damage. That instantly damages an overlord. So we first set up that row. On the second row here, we have what's called the song deck. And this is the deck of different songs that we'll put out that allow us to ultimately attack and kill the demons and overlords, mainly the overlords. Then down here, we have the the track with the Overlord and the demons. This demon stack right here is just a deck of demons, and we're going to draw one of these every turn towards the beginning of our turn for every number on this track. So see, at the beginning it's easy, there's only one, but as this metal track goes up, it gets harder and harder until we lose the game. There's also a set of Overlords, and you can choose to play on basically easy, medium, or hard. Easy would mean that you just turn over one Overlord, in this case, Zafan. And the way that when I explain the turnover, you'll understand the turnover, you'll understand the importance of this. And for a normal game, you'd play two. So these would be the two that we would have. Okay. Now, we're going to talk about our band, and then we'll talk about how we play the game and what the turn orders look like. Now, I do want to keep iterating that this is a prototype, and nothing in here is final as far as components are concerned, though I would imagine they're pretty close. They look pretty close to me. And you're going to be a fan of this artwork depending on your propensity to like heavy metal type stuff from the 80s, 90s, and that sort of thing. So, however, each of your bands, you can have up to four members in your band. And you're going to have a lead singer, a lead guitar, bass guitar, and a drummer in your band. And they all have special abilities and specialized decks. Now, in the prototype that I got, there were two bands. There was the Speedbach, band, and that consists of the bass guitarist Vince Woden, the lead guitarist Maybe, not her, sorry, the drummer Buddy Manny, and the lead singer Fred Mars. And then there's this bonus person, but we won't talk about that right now. And so on this band, though, we chose to take these guys, the Unholy Fog. And I did see that it doesn't matter. Like, you can mix and match, but it appears to me, well, it doesn't appear to me, it says right on the cards, and there's clearly a bonus, a synergy bonus for having people of the same band. So if you're playing Unholy Fog, for example, each of these folks has a special ability. So the Oz here is our lead singer, and he has the ability, says you may discard an attached instrument upgrade to have a player gain 1 decibel. If the player is in the Unholy Fog, they gain 2. So see, it's a bonus for having all your people from the same band. I think that's valuable. This is the character's health, and this is the starting decibel that they have. So they all start with a certain amount. And then you're going to draw cards. Sorry, I totally misspoke. I said starting, that's the limit. That's the decibel limit. That's the most that you can have. So if you have 3, that's the most you can have. Okay, but we're going to draw 6 cards. So when you start the game, you, like most deck builders, you're going to draw up to 6 cards. And we'll just take a look at what that looks like. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Now when we do that, we get to use this hand to play our round. So we're going to use the Oz, and we're going to demonstrate a round. So why don't we get right into that? We're going to just demonstrate this round right now and show you how it plays out. The first thing that happens, and the second thing that happens, is on a new player's turn is always bad. So we have these two overlords that are out right now, out of the 6 that we have to defeat to win the game. And again, on a normal game, you're going to play 2 at a time. So this is Zafan. His ability is the current player discards a card or loses 2 cards. So or loses 2 health. So for example, if we're playing the Oz, which we are, we have these 6 cards that we're going to play. And these are basic cards. So there's nothing special. But they do have a special one that's set up as the lead singer. We can either choose to discard one of these or lose 2 health. And then Cerberus says the current player discards a song card, which there isn't one at the beginning of the turn, or discards 2 decimal tokens. If there is no song card or decimal tokens, you lose 2 health. So you can see that the death is probably imminent. You lose health a lot. Now, here's the interesting thing. It's the death of your band members that ticks this track up. So if the Oz takes too much damage and dies, then that's when this goes up 1. And then he comes back full of health and everything, supported by the metal gods to come back and fight evil, right? So let's take a look at these cards. So based on the 2 Overlords cards, and by the way, just to give you some stats on them, you can see that they have a 6 health times the number of players. So if I'm playing a 4-player game like I demonstrated, they would have 24 health. Oh, and this one's 3 per number of players. So now the point is to defeat those Overlords. So we have these series of cards. Now, I've already either taken 4 damage or lost a card. So if I was to look at this, would I have taken the hits or lost a card. I could take two hits and lose a card, or four hits and not lose a card. Let's just say, for the sake of argument, he decided he was going to just take all the damage for now, because there's ways to heal, and cards, especially at the beginning, are quite important. So let's just say the Oz took the four damage. So he took some hits there, and now he's going to get to keep all these cards to play. The next thing we're going to do is, after he's done that, we still have another bad thing to contend with. Okay? Now, we have to draw demon cards equal to the number of the area where our metal token is at. So we would take this deck here, and we would draw one card. Now, we have a choice immediately. If I have enough decibel tokens, which basically does damage in this game, I could immediately kill the pit bear if I could spend four decibel to overcome his health. It'd be gone, and this effect wouldn't take place. But you can see, this is bad. Discard two cards and play another demon deck card. So we would have. So now we know we're going to lose two cards. That kind of sucks, right? But it is what it is. Now, let's talk about these cards. Roadies, these basic roadie cards, are our income. What we're going to use to basically gain more metal tokens. Okay, but there are other ways to do that. So, for example, we also have these power cords, which are one of the ways we can gain health and gain decibel tokens, right? But we also have these specials. We have warming up. So overturn one song card if this defeats an overlord, also gain health. So it's cool. And then we also have this starting equipment that we can attach. So let's just say, look, I don't think there's nothing out there that's worth two. There's something worth zero called surprise attack. So we can probably take that. Anyway, it does say if this is revealed. Oh, yeah, this one wouldn't be any good for us. It says if revealed during setup, it's blank. Shuffle it back into the metal deck. Otherwise, add one metal. Add one to the metal track and then remove this card from the game. So this is a bad card that's stuck in the deck, but we would normally reshuffle it and get out so it'd be replaced by this. That said, there's nothing in the metal row that we could purchase this turn with just two metal tokens. Now, are there some other ways for us to get metal tokens? Yes, there is. There's this attachment. It says when attached to it remains in play. When attached, on our turn, we're going to gain two metal tokens or one decibel token. Must be discarded when we play a song. So let's just say, look, we're not going to be able to buy much this turn, so we'll discard because of the effect of this demon, these roadies. Okay, but then we're going to have to draw another demon. So it says all players must discard two cards. Now we're really hosed, right? This was a terrible turn for us. We end up discarding two cards. So let's say we end up discarding these so we don't get any decibel tokens either. And we got two cards left after these demons are gone. That's a particularly rough start. But, you know, in a deck builder like this, you know, you do got some randomness like that. It can be pretty bad. These demons are immediately discarded after their effect. Now we get to play our cards. But, of course, we're not in a very good place to do that, right? So, anyway, let's say we play this warming up card. So we're going to play that card out of our hand. And that gives us the beginning of a song, or a song card. We don't know if it's the beginning, middle, or the end. But when something says overturn one song card, it means we overturn it and we place it out. This one says it's the beginning. It's profanity. It's the beginning. It says words like a lion released from a cage filled with hatred and covered in rage. That's the song, basically the lyrics of the song. It targets the overlord, and it's the beginning of the song. So we know that this song is going to target one of the overlords. That's that. Okay. Doesn't do anything else right now. Doesn't have any other effects. It will when we get to the end of the song. Okay. Then we have this item, which we could attach to ourselves, which we would, and it's going to give us two metal tokens or a decibel token. See, here's the thing. And it has one decibel. It adds to our decibel limit right there. So see, that would give us the ability to get four. I would just attach that to the Oz, and that would give us one decibel token that we have to spend, which is cool. Okay. And again, we didn't get to purchase anything from the metal deck, so that would be the end of his turn. And that's how the turns are going to go. Now, eventually, we are going to build out a song. Let me show you what that looks like. I don't know if I have these in any particular. So here's an end part of the song. It says, when the song is completed, all players gain one damage. It says, a glimmer of hope shines on high tower. The demon tries to retain his power. So that's right there. Let me see if I can find us a middle. That's another end. I'm going to see if we can locate a middle, another end. Uh-oh. Maybe I didn't shuffle these very well, but I thought I did. There's a middle. Okay, so once we complete this, we get to use it, right? So it says, the target is the Overlord. This one also would have had a target, but it doesn't matter. This one says, target the Overlord, but it doesn't do anything. It just means this targets the Overlord. This one says, target current player adds one decibel to each Overlord. That's pretty good. All players gain a health. That's great. Overlord increase the metal track by one. Okay, bummer. But then over here, we get to finish this off when the song is completed. All players gain one health. So then this song gets completed. All those things happen, and we get to get rid of the song, and we go on to the next one. And that's how we end up defeating these bad guys, because they end up getting a lot of metal tokens based on, decibel tokens based on the types of songs that come out. And plus, there's other ways, items and things like that, that allow you to damage them. Once you've defeated six overlords, you've won the game. Once you've gotten to the skull on the metal track, you have lost the game. And so play is going to continue like that. Having played a number of rounds of this game, here's what I'm going to tell you about it. Gods of Metal is, for the most part, a standard deck-building game with an interesting theme tied around it. The thing that sets it apart, there's two things. One, really positive, and one that I'm not sure how I feel about yet. The song cards, that is a big plus for me. It changes up the game and adds a new element to the deck-building genre, where you're trying to build this song deck from a different deck of cards, which is pretty cool. And then the other thing is the overlords, you know, defeating six overlords while having these demons come out. It seems pretty hard. Even in the medium mode, I was unable to get some things started sometimes because of the way the cards fell. That's a lot of randomness, too, because these demons do a lot of different things, and you really don't have a ton of ways outside of having enough decibel to kill them to mitigate the effects of these cards, right? So that's okay. That's not a plus or a minus, because there are ways through items and things like that to mitigate that. And as you get stronger and more powerful throughout the game, you're going to be able to do that. But of course, it gets also harder, where you're up to getting to a point where you're facing up to three demons, as well as the two overlords. The one thing that I saw that was a little challenging for me in comparison to other deck builders is most of the deck builders have a card or two or three that are very easy to get to acquire. Like, some of them you don't even have to pay to acquire. You can just say, I just want one of these. So you never go through a whole turn without being able to acquire something. I mean, one of the big points of a deck building game is to continue to beef up your deck. And then later on, when you have more powerful cards, you need to be able to cull your deck. And if those of you have been able to identify the very first major deck builder that came out, you'll know exactly what I'm talking about, because that was really the emphasis around it, was being able to build up your deck and chain these abilities together and then cull your deck of the weaker cards. So this does all of that except for the one element where you don't have an easy way to get some cheap cards up front in the beginning. You can see that if you get an unlucky draw, some of them are really, really expensive. And in the beginning, you're not going to have the metal tokens to be able to purchase them. I don't know if that's that much of a drawback. Again, I have to play it a whole bunch more times. Like I said, this is not really a review, this is a preview. However, if you like deck building games, this definitely scratches that itch for sure. And it has enough of a spin on it to feel different. One of the things I liked about Clank was it felt different when I sat down to play it. One thing that I liked about Aeon's End is it felt different than the standard deck builder. And this does too, because of the addition of the song deck and how that works. So anyway, that is my preview of my very short preview of Gods of Metal. We are going to get it to the table for a playthrough, but I want to play it a few times before we get there. And I have some other commitments to get that done before this, but I wanted to make sure that this video got up so you could see what this game is about as it was relaunched to Kickstarter on November 17th. And again, Christopher Brown, he designed one of the funnest games, one of my favorites in my top many games, and that is Slaughterville, which is a lot like a more modern version of A Touch of Evil or something like that, where you're moving to locations and having things happen. Really, really fun game, and I know they're producing a second version of that. That game was great. My friends loved it. I had a friend of mine that borrowed Slaughterville and just wouldn't get back to me for the longest time because they kept playing it, which was fine with me. I did eventually get it back from him, and I've played Slaughterville again since. It's one of those ones that's staying in my collection. Will this stay in my collection? I don't know. I'm going to have to play it a few more times, though I do tend to really like deck builder games. One, they're cooperative. I love cooperative games. Two, deck builder. Got a big plus there. Three, interesting, different theme. While I'm not a over-the-top metalhead, I do like that music, and I do get what's going on. It's kind of clever, and I like that a lot. So if this is a game for you, I hope this has helped you in checking it out and deciding it. We are going to do a more in-depth playthrough in the near future, but this is what we got so far, and I hope this has given you some good information. So thanks so much. Please like, share, and subscribe, and do remember that this is a prototype. This is not the final layout or anything of the game, as far as I know. Even though I have a feeling these are pretty set in stone. I mean, some of this artwork is super cool. I mean, check out this frenzied card. It's pretty neat. Yeah. So anyway, I do believe it's pretty close to finishing a finished product, though. I do believe that when the and I'm going to try and say I do believe at least four more times. It would appear to me that when they publish this, obviously the quality will go up quite a bit when it's formally published. I think this was a Game Crafter-made Kickstarter, you know, prototype, which makes sense. However, it's a really nice prototype. Anyway, guys, thanks for watching. Thanks for subscribing. Again, I hope this gave you the information you need. Please let me know what you think of Gods of Metal, if there's anything that appealed to you, or if you have any questions, I'll be happy to take them. Thanks, and talk to you soon. Bye-bye.